A year ago, this island was all about two men, one championship and one hell of a fight.
Kelly, on Lowndes. Oh, race leader at Lowndes. That is Lowndes. He's been taken out of it. In the most dramatic way, Rick Kelly is the new race leader. Rick Kelly is the champion for 2006.
Guess what? Not much has changed in 2007. After a season of amazing highs, gut-wrenching lows, record-breaking wins, and heart-breaking losses, here we go again.
Massive impact there for Lowndes.
Unbelievable! Whincup spins!
Oh, here comes Lowndes. Whoa!
Oh, no!
Got a car on its roof, it's Paul Morris.
Almost rolls the Castrol forward.
This one is worth the championship lead for Jamie Whincup.
But this time, there are more contenders, each one facing their own kind of pressure.
Garth's made some silly mistakes late these last couple of meetings where you think, well, he didn't make it at the start of the season, but now maybe the pressure is building.
You know, you couldn't have scripted what's happened in the last three or four rounds.
I think pressure's motivation and, you know, you've got to rise above it. And this weekend's going to come down to the guy who stands up and really grabs the championship with two hands and says, this one is mine.
And maybe that's what it boils down to. Who can handle the pressure? It's the one remaining question of the 2007 V8 Supercar Championship. So, let's get the answer. It's the grand finale, and it's over on 7.
Well, it's hard to think of a better setting to wrap up the V8 Supercar Championship of 07. Phillip Island is such a fitting backdrop. It's spectacular, it's fast, it's dangerous, it's exciting. It's everything the series has been so far this year. Hello, I'm Matthew White. Welcome to Championship Sunday, the Dunlop Grand Finale in every sense. Two more races now to decide who will win the 2007 title. And remember, there are now only three men left in the hunt. Race one yesterday was the perfect start for Garth Tander. He went from seventh in qualifying to first to gain maximum points. He beat Mark Scaifeholm, but Jamie Whincup finished third. Craig Lowndes was behind him and Rick Kelly behind Lowndes. And as a result, Rick is now officially out of the title hunt because the championship points show that it's all locked up at the top. Can you believe it? Tander has turned a 7-point deficit coming in here into equal standing with Whincup. Lowndes is now 23 points adrift. Remember, there's a maximum 48 points available in the two races remaining. It sets up one extraordinary last day of the championship. Good afternoon to Neil Crompton. It's all about points, Cromley, but it's also about pressure. We saw that in race one.
Hi, Matthew. Hi, everybody. Indeed, you are right. Yesterday, we talked about managing the little things for the key contenders, stuff like qualifying, like the starts, passing, strategy, pit stops. And yesterday, each of the key players had their little issues, beginning with Garth Tander in qualifying. Had a mistake. He fired off at turn two, rattled through the gravel, and that certainly hurt his cause. Here it is. You'll find that each of them in their own way had a little micro fumble one way or another. And this is where Garth Tander ended up being buried down seventh in the field. We thought that that might have put him in real strife, but turned out not to be the case. Rick Kelly, an awesome jump away from the line. And he did everything he could do to maximise that lead, but unfortunately made a little mistake. Great opportunistic moves here for Garth Tander around the outside at turn two. Made up a couple of spots, and here's the mistake that Rick Kelly made down at the hairpin turn four, running wide. And really at that point, and then there were three. That was the fact. Now, Jamie Whincup stopped, looked okay from this side of the car. However, on the left rear of the Team Vodafone Ford, a tiny fumble cost them some track position, and we know track position's king. Meanwhile, Tander had speed. They ran him long, and he was able to get clean air. Mark Scope's car developed some oversteer, and away he went. The Team Vodafone cars, however, were sandwiched between Todd Kelly and Rick Kelly. Craig was a bit grumpy about Todd protecting. Ultimately, he was able to get through. They did make contact at turn five at Siberia. Side-to-side contact. The stewards did nothing about that one afterwards. They didn't consider that it warranted any action. Craig's hands actually came off the steering wheel in the middle of that contact. Now, Jason Richards going off here at turn two. You may not think this is part of the championship picture, but in fact, what that did was it let Jamie Whincup off the hook, and that's how we got to 586 points apiece. So Garth Tander, the winner, Jamie Whincup moving up in third position because Jason went off, and there's a bit of a story attached to that, which I'll tell later. It's a remarkable turn of events.
Garth Tander gets his 14th race win. That's crucial in the overall scheme of things, because if they finish on equal points at the end of the day, he will win the championship by virtue of that. We talked about points, we've talked about pressure. Today is all about position.
That's right, and whoever does well now in race number two is going to have the edge, because that'll set up the scenario for race number three. So what we'll focus on in this second race is precisely where Tander and Whincup are. What they'll do here is play a chess game that'll then give us the ability to deliver the scenario for race number three, and who's got to do what. There's a couple of random elements, there always is. There's plenty of other fast guys in the field at the moment. We've talked a bit about the weather, but it won't arrive here in Victoria until about 8 or 9 o'clock tonight. However, the wind is blowing aggressively now from the north. It's been from the south on Friday and Saturday. That'll totally change the way these things behind us behave in those conditions. We'll see who plays that card well.
Well, settle in, folks. We've got a great day ahead of us here on 7. Race 2 is coming up right after the break. The championship is on the line.
Yes, love to have that number one on the door. To have, you know, Ford branded car with a number one would be sensational with us driving it. We've been able to achieve the ultimate goal, I think, for me, which is Bathurst. We've got Sandown, but yeah, the one thing that eludes me now is a championship.
Just because we had a good year last year and didn't get the prize doesn't instantly mean that I'm the worthy winner in 2007, because, you know, Jamie, Craig, the Vodafone guys have all done a fantastic job to get themselves in this position, and really it's going to be probably the hardest fought battle for the championship we've ever seen.
It will be a sad time to pull that number off the door, and, you know, pulling that off, I think, will give me a bit of motivation to come back next year and make sure it's back on at the end of 08, which again is not going to be easy.
This weekend it's just about letting the steering wheel do the talking and learning from what we've done all year, and I've never been in this position before. It's all pretty new to me, but I learned from what I did in Formula Ford and in go-karts and just move on, and really I just hope I enjoy the experience this weekend and do myself and the team proud.
History at this circuit, and another chapter will be written today when we crown the 2007 champion. They've come en masse under clear blue skies, a strong northerly wind which is staring down the back of them as they line up and grid up here on Gardiner Straight. There's Garth Tander starting from position one. Neil Crompton mentioned that races two and three will be all about position. On the next row back, it's an all-team Vodafone lineup. Jamie Whincup, the equal championship leader. He'll start from position three. Craig Lowndes, of course, next to him. And we must also make mention of Mark Scaife, who's on the front row alongside Tander after that second in race one. Scaife has a brand new car this weekend, car number 200. There's Lowndes. And here is our circuit.
And isn't this a great racing track to determine the outcome of this year's championship? 10 corners, just a tad under 4.5 kilometres, characterised by a lot of medium high-speed corners and a couple of very tricky slow ones. Turns 4 and 8 are only 70 kilometres an hour, but one turn that we love to focus on is the one that we call Hayshed. And there it is at turn number 6. 220 kilometres an hour in the mid-corner, and when you've got it right, you're about 1 millimetre from disaster on the outside of the road. Over the years, it's certainly caused a bit of chaos, and it's a wonderfully rewarding piece of racetrack.
Will it reward Toll HSV with another championship? Rick Kelly will hand over the number one at the end of this season. Welcome all our international viewers, our viewers on bigpondsport.com, and of course on 7 Network. You're about to see the grand finale come to a complete halt. At the end of today, we will know who will win the 2007 Drivers' Championship. Tander versus Scaife on the front row. Whincup and Lowndes on the second row. The brothers Kelly, Rick and Todd Kelly, from positions 5 and 6. Making up our top 10, Mark Winterbottom and Russell Ingall. And then we find Will Davison and Greg Murphy, who made up five spots in race one yesterday. Not a lot of changes in the top 10 order. Only Jason Richards was the one who sort of bailed out at the end there, and we talked about the mistake that Jason had. It cost him dearly, and it also helped out Jamie Whincup. There's Shane Van Gisbergen, the young Kiwi driver, starting from position 14. Cam McConville, Super Cheap Auto Racing, or Paul Wheel Racing, will close down at the end of today, and that's where Jason Richards will start from position 17. He could have been in third.
And further to that story, what happened was that when he got down to turn number two yesterday, he wasn't 100% certain as he came out of fourth gear whether in fact he'd gated third or first gear. So to compensate, he kept his foot on the clutch pedal and just ran it in neutral for a moment, because things happen very quickly down at turn two. You arrive very quickly, a big direction change, a little bit of brake. Problem is, when the engine idles on these cars, and in particular his car, the idle speed drops down to about 800 RPM. The power steering doesn't work down there. So it locked up in the steering. So in a moment's panic, he then gassed it up. And then the power steering, of course, came alive and he fired off into the paddock. So he was pretty forlorn about all that at the end of yesterday's play. Brake rotor problem for Owen Kelly, and damage on Paul Morris's car as a result of making contact with Max Wilson at turn 8, which incidentally the stewards looked at and determined that there was no further action to be taken there. Jason Bright, in case you don't know,